Background of PA. You must know that in the olden days, there were various kingdoms which were ruled by monarchs. So, how do you think the kingdom was run? Do you think it was the king who directly managed the administration of the kingdom? No, of course not. In the olden days, the administrative functions were managed by a chosen few people who were responsible for general administration functions such as maintaining law and order and collecting revenues with little or no welfare activities. These administrators were selected by the monarchs and were no better than their personal servants. However, as monarchy was replaced by a democratic, socialist, or a capitalist state and with the advent of industrial revolution, the government forayed into trade and commerce. Next, the industrial revolution gave way to imperialism, nationalism, and internationalism, which added on to the widening avenues of government duties and responsibilities. As times changed, the objective of public administration also underwent a change, and by the 19th century, an organized approach to public servants and public administration was adopted. This approach was based on an exhaustive legal framework, replacing the patriarchal and hereditary function with bureaucracy. The interpretation and translation of those policies and laws into actions and carrying them out is the difficult part. The public administrators therefore have to play an important role in running the government as machinery. Let us now learn about introduction to public administration in detail. Hence, public administration today has become an integral part of the government, the state, the people, and the way they function with each other, because all aspects of citizens' life are influenced and decided by the government. Public administration is especially crucial because it is not enough to make policies and laws on paper. Lesson 1. Dimensions of Philippine Public Administration and Governance. Lesson Objective. Discuss and explain the dimensions and perspectives of Philippine public administration and governance in the context of bureaucracy. Meaning of public administration. Public administration is both an academic discipline and a field of practice. Public administration houses the implementation of government policy and an academic discipline that studies this implementation and that prepares civil servants for this work. PA is a field of inquiry with a diverse scope. Its fundamental goal is to advance management and policies so that government can function. Definition of public administration. Rosen Bloom, 1989. The process of PA consists of the actions involved in affecting the intent or desire of a government. It is thus the continuously active, business part of government, concerned with carrying out the law, as made by the legislative bodies, or other authoritative agents, and interpreted by courts, through the processes of organization and management. PA is the action part of government. The means by which the purposes and goals of government are realized. PA as a field is mainly concerned with the means for implementing political values. PA differs from political science in its emphasis on bureaucratic structure and behavior and its methodologies. PA differs from administrative science in the evaluative techniques used by non-profit organizations, because profit-seeking organizations are considerably less constrained in considering public interest in their decision-making structures and the behavior of their administrators. De Guzman, 1993. From a very broad perspective, PA may be viewed to refer not only in activities carrying out or implementing policies and programs of the government, but also to the processes and contents of these policies and programs. From a broader perspective, PA may refer to the cooperative human action, whether within the public bureaucracy, the private sector, or in non-governmental organizations aimed at delivering services to the people. Caden, 1971, is a cooperative group effort in a public setting. Covers all three branches: executive, legislative, and judicial, and interrelationships. Has important role in the formulation of public policy and is, thus, part of the political process. As a field of study and practice, it has been influenced by human relations approach. Is closely associated with numerous private groups. Waldo, 1955. PA is the organization and management of men and materials to achieve the purposes of government. PA is the art and science of management as applied to the affairs of the state. Views of public administration as both an art and a science. As an art, PA involves creativity, leadership, a good sense of the intangibles in administration. This view is closely to the practice of PA. As a science, there is a body of knowledge or theories that can explain or predict phenomenon or variables in the field of PA. The PA theories and concepts are built based on empirical research using systematic methods. These theories can be used not only to explain what is also considered an applied discipline. It has practical use for government, particularly in improving government performance. It prepares persons for careers in public service and trains them to be good public administrators. As per Marx, Marx defines administration as, administration is determined action taken in pursuit of a conscious purpose. It is the systematic ordering of affairs and the calculated use of resources aimed at making those happen which one wants to happen. As per Frederick K. Lane, Frederick K. Lane defines administration as, organizing and maintaining human and fiscal resources to attain a group's goals. What is the PA subject matter or focus to be studied? Example of PA as a field of study. How a policy is made and implemented. The interrelationship between government institutions. Human resource development. Impact of environmental regulation on communities and economic activities. The behavior and attitude of public officials as they perform their official duties. Leadership styles of public managers. Mechanisms adopted by poverty-focused programs. Scope of public administration. It is the basis of government. It is the instrument of change in the society. It plays vital role in the life of the people. It is an instrument for executing laws. It is a stabilizing force in the society as it provides continuity. It is instrument of national integration in the developing countries which are facing class wars. Difference between traditional public administration and development administration. Development administration. Change oriented. Goal and result oriented. Flexible and dynamic. Its objectives complex and multiple. Concerned with new tasks. Believes in decentralization. Stress on planning. Traditional public administration. Status quo oriented. Emphasis on economy efficiency. It is hierarchical and rigid. Its objectives are simple and limited. Concerned with routine operations. Believes in centralization. Docs not rely much on planning. It resists organizational change. Difference between public and private administration. In order to function efficiently, the public sector organizations are borrowing heavily from the business knowledge, administration, and process orientation of the private organizations. However, there still remains a considerable difference between these two administrative practices. The following are some of the similarities between public and private administration. The accounting aspects like maintenance of accounts, filing, statistics, and stocking are the same. They also share the same pool of manpower. The managerial aspects of planning, organizing, coordinating and controlling are the same for public and private administration. Public administration is like any other administration which is carried out in public interest. Agriculture, health, defense, commerce, justice, research, security, labor, transportation, energy. Historical and legal approach. The historical and legal approach to the study of public administration focuses on the administrative systems, process, and policies practiced in the past and then try to interpret them relevantly in the context of present times. Some scholars feel that this approach provides rich details regarding what did and did not work in the past. For instance, the application of the principle of unity of command implies one subordinate, one superior relationship. Every subordinate is answerable and accountable to one boss at one time. This helps in avoiding communication gaps and feedback and response is prompt. Unity of command also helps in effective combination of resources, that is, physical, financial resources, which helps in easy coordination and, therefore, effective organization. Bureaucracy in the Philippines. Government relies on the formal organization, more popularly known as bureaucracy, to carry out its functions and perform its role in society. Government activities are discharged out by these organizations, which vary in sizes and functions but have common goals, that is to protect and promote the welfare of the people. In our country, one major element that comprises the bureaucracy is the large number of issue networks that have the capabilities and means to influence policymaking and other governmental processes. In reality, to borrow Robert Dahl's concept, the whole Filipino society may be considered as one big issue network, as the prime movers, meaning, everyone can impinge the way the government works, because all of us have a stake in it. However, we tend to look upon those in the government as the only prime movers, because they are the ones who stand out, meaning they are the dominant actors or decision makers, when actually, those people are only part of those issue networks that were able to rise into power and became the policy politicians who are experts in using networks. We all have a role to play in our society, and we all know the fact that there are so many problems and issues that the bureaucracy has to address, but it does not necessarily mean that we have to bombard the bureaucracy with tons of policy agendas, because that will not help in solving the problem. In fact, too much policy agendas may become unmanageable, and it may even produce conflict with other policy agendas, thus causing more dissension, instead of consensus. This lesson ends here. Thank you.